Okay. Okay, just 1 minute. Yeah, can you see the screen also?
Yeah, it's just conversion process, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, at least okay. I could see. I don't know about others.
Okay. Okay, so let's start. So we'll start with the next topic today, new topic today. We almost completed all the things which were related to the project, like new implementation. Like we configured the, there's some background noise. Can you please mute yourself? Okay. Yeah, so we already completed the topics which are related to the new implementation. Like we configured the enterprise structure and some of the configurations like new credit management. We seen the output determination. We have seen some of the changes in the processes of from procurement, sales and distribution, and MRP live. So there are some small topics which are still pending, which are like which are part of this procurement, sales, and MRP. We'll talk during the conversion project. Okay, so now what is a conversion? So as I told you earlier, there are basically three kind of projects that we'll be working on. One is the new implementation, where customer is implementing SAP for the first time, or customer is already using SAP, but they don't want to continue with their current SAP system. They want to start from scratch. So that is a new implementation. There is a second kind of project, which is called as a conversion. Conversion means customer is already using SAP. Let's say from 10 years, customer is already using SAP. And now he wants his existing system to be migrated to SAP S for HANA. Okay, so that is something which we need to understand. What is a conversion process and what are the different phases, or what are the different tools, what are the different processes that you need to execute during the conversion? Okay, so again, just one more time, just to make sure that you understand what is conversion. Let me give you the example. Let's say you are using EHP 6 today, and now you want to move to EHP 7. So normally what you do, normally you perform the conversion project, normally you perform the upgrade project, right? Using your same EHP 6 system, you deploy some more new patches and you convert your EHP 6 system to EHP 7. That is a kind of upgradation of or the conversion. On the other hand, the second kind of option is you are using EHP 6, you want to use EHP 7, so you completely destroyed your EHP 6 system and completely re-implement EHP 7. That cannot be termed as a conversion project. Conversion project is when you are using your existing system as it is and you are performing the upgrade on the same system to convert it to the new system. Right? Is it clear? Conversion process. So you should be now able to understand what is the difference between a completely new implementation and conversion. I'll talk about these five phases. This is something which I'll show you practically instead of talking about them now. Let me proceed to this slide, which is very important. Now, as I told you, conversion project will be done only when the customer is already using SAP system. Now the question is, let's say you visited a client and he is interested in converting his existing system to SAP S/4HANA. Now, what are the different things that you need to check to make sure that whether the client is really ready to be migrated to S4 or not? So just for example, first thing that you will ask him is, which version of SAP are you using currently? And if customer is saying he is using the version which is above ERP 6.0, above ERP 6.0 means ECC 6.0, any EHP, starting from EHP 0 to EHP 7, whatever different versions are available within ERP 6.0 or higher, then customer is already set to be migrated to SAP S4, because the migration path which is provided by SAP for the existing customers, it is only available for the customers who are already on ERP 6 or above. So if you are already on ERP 6 or above, you are ready to be migrated to S4 in one single step. What does this mean? Let's say a new customer you visited, you asked him, okay, which version are you using? And he said, we are using very old version 4.6. You know, right? SAP started with R3. There were different versions, 4.6, 4.7, 5.0. Then they came up with SAP ERP 6.0. So if customer is already using SAP ERP 6.0, migration can be done in one step because SAP has provided a migration path for the customers who are above 6.0. But as I gave you the example, you visited a customer and he is saying we are using 4.7. So does it mean that this customer cannot move to SAP S4? This customer can also move to SAP S4, but not in one step. They have to follow two-step procedure. What does this mean? Two-step procedure means, since S4 can be migrated only from 6.0, and 4.7 can only be migrated till 6.0, the first project they need to do is migrating from 4.7 to 6.0. So you first perform a project in which your existing 4.7 will be upgraded to 6.0, and then you perform second project from where your 6.0 application will be performed or migrated to SAP S4. So in short, simple, whatever is written here, instead of looking into this, this is...
So Gaurav, I have a question here.
Yes, Raj.
So for this process, say if you're going for the two-step process, how the timelines will get affected, or what are the, say it's a huge enterprise operating from multiple countries, so if they're in ECC 6, how long it takes is a one step, and if it is a different version, so how long usually take the timelines if it is a two step? I think we need to consider the testing and all other efforts, right?
Yes, Raj. So see, Raj, timeline nobody can provide you. It all depends upon the processes customer is using. It all depends upon how much data they are using. It all depends upon which approach they are selecting. Okay, so just to give you a simple example, when we go for the project, we propose two or three different scenarios to the customer. In one of the scenarios, they can be migrated to SAP S4 within 1 year. In some other scenarios, it can take up to 3 years. So it is all the approach. Like, for example, I can give you a simple example. Now SAP supports migration from your ECC to SAP S4. So even if you are not using HANA database on your ECC, you can directly move to SAP S4, in which during the conversion, your database also can be migrated to HANA. Now this approach is available, but a lot of customers, what they say, okay, we don't want to go in one single migration approach. We want to follow step by step. So first we want to go for HANA, and then we'll go for SAP S/4HANA. So although SAP provides a approach in which you can migrate in a shorter duration, but customers, in order to avoid their risk, they say, okay, we want to go one by one. So if they go for SAP S/4HANA with HANA database in one single shot, it can be done in 1 year. While if they go for HANA first, then they perform their EHP upgrade. So then they want to go for new GL accounting. So it can take up to 3 years also. So nobody can commit on the timelines. It all depends upon the customer's approach, what they are selecting. But yes, one thing for sure, if they are going for two-step approach, if the customer is not using SAP ECC 6.0 or above today, then definitely the timeline will increase, because they need to perform two separate projects. The first project will be migrating from your current 4.7 to 6.0, which will definitely take some time, and then from there to SAP S/4HANA. So timeline will definitely increase.
Okay, so as the cost also, right? So does the cost?
Yes, definitely. More time means more cost.
Yeah, even for fees and licenses, other stuff for SAP also might cost more money.
Raj, let me just complete this. Maybe you will be getting a lot of answers in the time I go through the slides.
Okay. Sure. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. So let me just complete this two or three slides. You will be getting a lot of answers. And then if you have any questions, I'll give you the time to ask that. So I hope you got this point. Very simple. If it is 6.0 and above, you don't need to see all this. Huh? I'll tell about this also. Just understand one thing. If my customer is above 6.0, any EHP from 0 to 7, he is ready to be migrated in one single step. If not, if customer is not using 6.0 or above, he is on 4.7, 4.6, 5.0, or whatever different versions were available before 6, in that case, SAP has still not provided a direct path from those older versions to SAP S/4HANA. And the only option available is you have to perform two-step conversion process, which is first you move from your existing version to 6.0, and then from 6.0, you go to SAP S/4HANA. Okay, now what is written here is same thing. So what it is saying is for a one-step conversion, your system needs to have a minimum release level. The following start releases are supported. So you can see it is starting from here. SAP ERP 6.0, EHP 0 to 7. Now, whatever these three different things that you can see, they are above 6.0. So SAP Business Suite powered by HANA, which means you are using SAP EHP 7 system on HANA database. Obviously more than 6.0, right? Or maybe you are already using Simple Finance. So this is even advanced. So you don't need to think about whether they are using HANA database or whether they are using Simple Finance or not. Simple, just perform this check and you will get an answer. So customer, if they are using 6.0 and above, any HP, it can be HP 0, 1, 2, 3, any, then single step conversion is possible. If not, then you need to follow the two-step conversion process. So for all the older releases, conversion will be performed using two-step conversion process. This is a very important question. Whenever you will go for conversion project, this is the first thing that you need to check. Okay. Now here, let me tell you something. Let's say, for example, there are different kind of scenarios possible now. When customer wants to perform the conversion project, I'll give you some two or three examples. Let's say first example, customer is using SAP ECC or maybe SAP ERP or SAP R3 4.7, which is very traditional. So in SAP R3 system 4.7, there was no new GL accounting. I'm talking from finance point of view. Okay, no HANA database, obviously 4.7 cannot run on HANA. Okay, and definitely no EHP. Now, in order to move from your current SAP 4.7 to SAP S/4HANA, as I told you, you need to follow two-step conversion project. Two-step is minimum. If I am a customer, I have a choice that I can perform the migration in two steps. Now, which two steps it can be? There are multiple options. For example, the first option is, first I migrate my existing 4.7 to EHP 7, latest 6.0 system EHP 7 without HANA database. Okay, first option is I move to EHP 7 without HANA database, and in second step, I move to EHP 7 on non-HANA database to SAP S/4HANA on HANA database. So my database migration is happening in step two. Second option is I migrate to EHP 7 with HANA database in first step. Okay, so from 4.7 to EHP 7 on HANA database in one first step itself. So my second step will be simpler because I'm already using HANA database. Second step will be migrating from EHP 7 on HANA to SAP S/4HANA. There can be third scenario. If customer wants to reduce the risk and he is okay with more timeline. So he will say, okay, let me go one by one. Let me first move from 4.7 to EHP 7 without HANA database. Second project I will do just to upgrade my database. So HANA database will be the completely separate project. And third project that I will do is I'll go for SAP S/4HANA. Okay. Now, as I told you, new GL accounting is also a very important topic here. So again, the first thing that I told you, customer will move from 4.7 to EHP 7. So here, customer will take a decision whether during this upgrade to EHP 7, he will activate new GL accounting or not. So there can be fourth scenario, which is customer will first migrate from 4.7 to EHP 7. First project. Second project, customer will implement new GL accounting, completely separate project, second project. Third project, he will upgrade his database to SAP HANA. And finally, the fourth project, which is migration from SAP ECC EHP 7 on HANA database to SAP S/4HANA. So as I told you, that timeline totally depends upon which approach customer is selecting. Some of the customers will say, we want to perform the upgrade as soon as possible. Minimum steps you perform and convert my system to SAP S/4HANA. On the other hand, some of the customers will say, okay, let's go one by one. Okay, we are not bothered about the timeline, but we want to make sure that each activity is done one by one in order to avoid the risk. Okay, so these are the different options available to the customers. They can first come to EHP 7, then they can perform a separate project on SAP HANA database, and then they finally move to SAP S/4HANA. Just 1 minute, there are some, okay, I'll answer the questions at the once I complete these 2-3 slides. This will give you more detailed picture now. So this is a conversion process, and as you can see, this is my current ECC system. This is my SAP business suite. Now, this is obviously ECC 6.0 because we are talking about one step conversion process. So we are assuming here that you are already on SAP ECC 6.0 and above. So let's say this is ECC 6.0 EHP 7 system where you are using traditional SAP GUI. You are using SAP ERP core, which was a ERP core available in the EHP 7 system. And from database point of view, you are either using HANA database already, or maybe you are still on non-HANA database, right? So this is your starting position. You are starting from here, from ECC, EHP, and EHP 0 to 7. On the other hand, you can see this is my SAP S/4HANA system. In SAP S/4HANA, from GUI point of view, you are getting the option of traditional GUI. So you can still continue to use the older screens. Plus you are getting the option of SAP Fiori. Okay. From the core point of view, the core system point of view, here you were using SAP ERP core. Now it is SAP S/4HANA core, which is also called as digital core. And from database point of view, you only have one option, that is HANA. So this is your beginning position and this is where you want to reach. Now, in order to reach from here to here, you need a lot of tools. Okay, what are these tools? Maintenance planner, simplification database, pre-check reports, software update manager. These are the four important tools. Okay, I'll tell you what exactly these tools are responsible for and what are the steps that you need to perform in the conversion project. So I think first doubt is clear. When you are moving from SAP, existing SAP to SAP S/4HANA, if you want to perform one step conversion process, is you must be on SAP ECC 6.0 or above. If not, you need to perform at least two steps. That is, first you move from ECC 4.7 to ECC 6.0. And then you move from ECC 6.0 to SAP S/4HANA. Now let's say my customer has already migrated to SAP ECC 6.0, or he is already using SAP ECC 6.0. So this is a starting position. Now he called you and he told you, I am planning to migrate my existing ECC to SAP S/4HANA, can you tell me which of my business processes will be impacted? Also, very importantly, not only standard business processes, I also want to know, because I'm using SAP from last 10 years, I created a lot of Z reports, I created a lot of Z forms, a lot of Z objects. So I want to know whether all my Z objects will work or which of the Z objects will be impacted. Okay, these are very important two questions. You cannot convert the customer's ECC system to SAP S/4HANA and then telling him that, oh, this is not working. That should not be done, right? You need to tell the customer in the beginning itself that if you migrate to SAP S/4HANA, these are some of the features which are not supported in S/4HANA. And these are some of the reports that you are using currently in as a Z reports, which will not work because the architecture in S/4 has been changed. Okay, so let's say, for example, you visited a customer, the customer who is running ECC EHP 6.7 system, and you he's asking you that, can you tell me what will be the impact on my existing business processes? So what you will do? Will you show him the simplification list? SAP has provided a simplification list, right? In which you can see everything, what is supported, what is not supported. If you show the simplification list to him, if there are 20 processes which are explained from procurement point of view, he will say, out of this 20, tell me only which is relevant to me. Don't show me all the 20 processes. I'm not using all those 20 processes. So don't, you don't need to show him the generic, like what is supported and what is not. He is more bothered about his own processes. He will tell you, don't show me what SAP is showing you as a simplification list. Don't show me, let's say credit management is not supported. I'm not using credit management at all. Then why are you showing me credit management changes? Now, what you need to do in that case, you need to understand his system. You will open his system. You will see, okay, whether he is using credit management or not, he's using material ledger or not. So it is a big exercise, right? Maybe from the standard system point of view, it will take less time because you just need to see the configuration, whether this is activated or not, that is fine. What about the Z codes? If he's asking you, can you tell me which of my Z reports, Z forms will work? So are you going to check one single Z reports, single custom codes, each and everything in detail? That is practically not possible. So what is the solution? Solution is SAP has provided some tools which will automatically perform the scan in customer's existing system. So you will be using these tools like maintenance planner, simplification database in the customer's existing system to understand which of the standard business processes will be impacted and which of the custom codes will be impacted. So this maintenance planner is a tool which will check in the existing system of the client, which of the standard business processes are not supported or impacted. It will tell you which business functions are available or not, which add-ons are available or not, and which industry solutions are available or not. Just for example, customer is using the some of the add-on or maybe industry specific solution. Let's say customer is using retail solution, IS retail. So when you run this maintenance planner, it will perform the scan and it will tell you whether IS retail can work as it was working earlier or there are some adjustments required. So from standard system point of view, it checks whatever functionalities you are using in your current system, plus it checks the add-ons and it checks the industry specific solutions. So this will give you the standard processes list which will be impacted. Once that list is available, it will be very easy for you. You can share this with client. See, this is the scan that we performed in your system. And according to this scan, these are the processes which will be impacted. So it will give him more confidence because he knows that you have performed this check in his current system and whatever you highlighted, he will agree that they are using because that is something which is automatic. You are not doing something manually. So whatever they are using, that report itself will come. So he will be knowing what are the standard processes which will be impacted. And second check that you will perform is this custom code analyzer, which will tell him, okay, you are using this 100 custom codes as of today in your current system. Out of this 100 custom codes, 80 will work as it is, while these 20 are not supported. Now, when you say they are not supported, it may happen that this 20 which you highlighted, they were created around, let's say, 5 years back, but nobody is using them. So not only you will get which 20 are not supported, it will also show you, this custom code analyzer, it will also show you whether they are really used or not. Okay, so looking at this report, customer can easily make a decision that out of this 20, I want to perform the adjustments only into 2 or 3, because remaining 15, 17, I'm not using at all. Right, so that detailed level of reporting, that detailed level of analysis will be provided to you by these tools. You don't need to do anything manually. You don't need to compare the simplification list with each and every functionality available in current system. Okay, you will be running these tools and it will give you the complete information. Now, who will run these tools? As a functional consultant, are you going to use these tools? No, these are the technical tools, okay? So in order to perform this analysis, you need the help of your technical consultant. They will be executing this tool, but final report will definitely come to you so that you can discuss the final report with the business. Okay, and you take a decision like what exactly the customer wants to do. So let's say you identified SD credit management, which the customer is using, it is not supported, it will be migrated to FSCM. So you take a decision, yes, that is fine with customer, and you will accordingly incorporate that in the design document. Okay, so whatever checks you are performing, this maintenance planner, simplification database, all these checks are happening in ECC itself. You are still not migrated to S4. All these checks are getting performed where at your ECC system, at your current system. Okay, finally, there is pre-check reports. This is again one tool. This is a final check which will performed in your existing system to check the system readiness, whether it is ready to be migrated to S4 or not. So what are the checks which are carried out in the pre-check reports? It is like definitely your version. The first check it will be performed is a version, whether your version is supported in one step migration or not. Second is whether the preparation activities you have completed or not. We'll talk about what are the preparation activities. Third is, as a part of preparation activities, there are some financial reconciliations which must be done before you migrate to S4. So whether your financial data is reconciled or not. So all these checks are performed as the last step in this process. And once these checks are passed, then only you can use this tool called a software update manager to convert your existing system to S4. So this software update manager is a main tool which will be used to actually perform the conversion, actually perform the upgradation. The software update manager is not a new tool. Even maintenance planner and simplification database definitely is a new tool, but maintenance planner, software update manager, if you ask this to technical consultants, they are already aware of this, because even when they were migrating from EHB 6 to EHB 7, they were using these tools. Okay. So software update manager is a tool which will be actually used to perform the conversion from your ECC to SAP S4. Now, as I told you, if you are not on HANA database already, okay, I have given you the example here. It may be on HANA database, it may not be on HANA database. So do I need to carry out a separate project first to migrate to SAP HANA and then to SAP S4 HANA? The answer is no, because the software update manager provides an option where you can migrate to HANA database and SAP S4 HANA as an application in one single step. Okay, so there is an option called as DMO. Okay, installation of new software, automatic conversion, and if needed, database conversion to SAP HANA. This is called as DMO, database migration option. So when you migrate from ECC to SAP S4 using the software update manager, you can specify that I not only want to migrate to SAP S4 HANA, but I also want to upgrade my database from traditional database to SAP HANA. Okay, now let me answer some of the questions. If you have any questions, please write or just unmute yourself.
Hi, Gaurav.
Yes.
This is Sri. I got the point. Like here, you gave an example of conversion from earlier versions before 6 to HANA, and also from 6 and up upper versions like 7 to HANA. But what happens if they want totally use a third option, like they want to rewrite the whole thing in HANA instead of going for a conversion?
No, you are saying they want to completely start from scratch.
Scratch, yeah.
Then it is not a conversion project. I told you, conversion is only when you are using your existing system and you are performing the upgrade on that. If you decided that you want to completely scrap your existing system and you want to start with a fresh system, that is kind of new implementation. Conversion is only when you are using the same system and you are performing the upgrade on top of your existing system. Even the hardware that you will be using, that will be same.
Okay, got it.
Hey Gaurav, this is Suresh here.
Yes, Suresh.
Hello. Yeah, see, assume that the customer is going to have a different database. Say, assume that Oracle, and if they're going to go for the conversion, it is necessary that they have to go with a simple finance first, and only then they can go with a simple logistic. Or they can see, because that is a process which they have to follow, is it? They have have this. Without simple finance, they can go with a simple logistic.
No. Suresh, see, that is the reason I explain you this. Let's see. What you are saying here is, if you are on ECC, any HP, okay, ECC 6.0, any HP, mm-hmm. Nothing is mandatory. Even if you are not using HANA database, you don't need to carry out a separate project. You can migrate to SAP S4HANA in one step. And obviously, we are not using simple finance here. So we are migrating one step to SAP S4HANA. So simple finance is not a prerequisite if you want to move to SAP S4.
Uh-huh. So you mean to say that Okay, got it.
Maybe if you are confused from here, let me explain this slide so once again. What I'm saying here is, you must be on any of this. Okay, I'm not saying these are mandatory, any of this. So SAP ERP 6.0, EHP 0 to 7. This is definitely not using SAP Simple Finance, right? So mm-hmm. From here also, you can directly go to SAP S4.
Okay. But you mean to say that simple finance is not mandatory because they can have without the simple finance, they can go with the simple logistic.
No, see, Suresh, when you talk about SAP S4HANA, S4HANA consists of both finance as well as logistics.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, see, when again coming to basics, like when SAP introduced SAP Simple Finance, at that time, only financial processes were simplified. Logistics processes were as it is.
Yeah.
Okay, and then they came up with SAP S4HANA, where addition to financial processes, they also simplified logistics processes. So when SAP S4HANA 15.11 was launched, it was not only simplified logistics, it was simple finance plus simple logistics. So when you are moving to SAP S4HANA, you are getting both.
Right, okay.
Yes, Terry is asking the question, can you run the maintenance planner in ECC to check for changes without installing DMO? Yes, that is same thing, Terry, we need to do. See, simple thing, if I talk in the layman term, if I am a customer and if I am interested in SAP S/4HANA, the first thing that will I like to know is, if I move to SAP S/4, what will happen to my existing business processes and what will happen to my existing reports? Till the time I'm not getting this correct information, it will be very risky for me to migrate to S/4, right? So if I am in a position where currently I'm using ECC system and I want to know what will be the impact on my standard business practices and what will be the impact on my Z reports, I cannot take a decision. So what I need to do, I need to run this maintenance planner and custom code analyzer in my existing ECC system to find out what will be the impact on my standard business processes and what will be the impact on my custom code. And once I know, I have the list of, let's say, functionalities which are impacted or list of custom codes which will be impacted, then I can take a decision whether I want to go for SAP S/4HANA or not. So whatever checks you are performing in ECC itself. Yeah, Terry is asking another question. Is there a new function in ECC 6 to run the maintenance planner? No, maintenance planner is a tool. Okay, and when we are saying that we will be running this in our ECC system, this doesn't mean our existing client. For technical things, they always use client 000. And these tools are available separately. Okay, maintenance planner and all these tools, software update manager, these are the external tools for which you need to pay the licensing fees definitely. Okay, and using these tools, you can verify what will be impacted in your current ECC system. So if this is, see, as I told you, maintenance planner, simplification database, and software update manager, if you speak to the technical consultants, these are the tools which are available from ES. These are not the new tools. They were using this when they were migrating from EHP 6 to EHP 7 also. May not be simplification database, but maintenance planner and software update manager, they are used from ES.
Gaurav.
Yeah. Yes.
You mentioned a few steps earlier. Could you repeat that? I think there are like three steps, something you said. If the client is on an older version, like 4.7, he can go from 4.7 to this new version with directly
ECC 6.
ECC 6, that's one, step one. And the step two is from 6 to SAP S/4HANA. You also mentioned somewhere that from 4.7, he can directly go to HANA database. Something you mentioned, 3 points. Could you?
Yes. See, it is like.
I'm going to write it down.
Yes. Yeah. So it is like from 4.7 to ECC without HANA database. Okay. So you migrated, let's say, to EHP 7, but you are using the same traditional database. Okay. This is step one.
Yeah.
Second step is you migrated your database from traditional database to SAP HANA.
Okay,
which means now you are on EHP 7 on HANA database. And third step is you migrated from EHP 7 on HANA database to SAP S/4HANA.
Okay.
Okay.
Got it. And Gaurav, these points, like when you say these points, I mean, you are giving very valuable information verbally. Would it be possible for you to write it down on the screen so that, you know, we can write it down or we save that information? Or
Yes. I'll do so.
Notes at the end of the class or something. You know, we like to have some kind of notes so that we can, you know, go through later on.
No, definitely. We are going to talk about, because I'm just giving you the basic overview as of now. When we'll discuss in detail, I'm going to show you all these tools. All these tools in the sense like functional tools from the cockpit point of view in the system. So at that time, I'll give you the complete overview. Even the, I will use the notepad and that notepad I will share with you.
Yeah, that'd be great. Or even if you have some kind of screens, you know, PowerPoint content, something, that would be great.
Yes.
Thank you, Gaurav.
I got one more question. See, I think if the customer, if they wanted to go with the simple finance go live first, and then if they wanted to go with the simple logistic after maybe one year, because then they are not going with the, on the same time. So how it's going to affect the other process if I'm going to have the finance first?
It will not impact. See, if you are, again, this is another approach. So there can be a lot of approach. Whatever customer can think, it will create an approach, right? So this is another approach. The customer currently is using ECC HP6.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And now he has decided, okay, I don't want to go for SAP S/4HANA 1610. Maybe I just want to go for simple finance. Okay. And after 1 year, I'll move to SAP S/4HANA. Right, this is the scenario that you are talking about.
Yes.
So in that case, if he's going only for simple finance, only his financial processes will be simplified. Their logistics processes, MM, SD, PP will be unimpacted. They will remain as it is. No change. Okay. Mm-hmm. And only when they will migrate from simple finance to SAP S/4HANA, then only they will get all the other simplified processes in logistics. So as I told you, your starting point is when you are migrating to SAP S/4HANA, your starting point is this. So you are already running SAP Simple Finance on-premise edition 1503, or you are already using SAP Simple Finance add-on 1.0. So these were the two versions of Simple Finance.
Right, okay. So it's again one more process, right? Go from Simple Finance then to S/4HANA. Right, okay. Yeah, okay.
Yes, that will again add to your timelines and the cost, because you are again following the approach which is longer.
No, they were customer generally, they go on with the cautious approach, right, on this. Yeah.
It depends, like it is based on the customer to customer. Some of the customers wants to implement S/4HANA as soon as possible. Some of the customers are taking this project as a 3 years project, and they are dividing it into first migrating to EHP7, then installing new GL, then installing the HANA database, then installing the Simple Finance, then installing the S/4HANA. Some of the customers, they are saying directly in one shot, we want to go for SAP S/4HANA. So it all depends upon the nature of industry, the how many business processes they are using, what is the data. It all depends upon that. So small customers, they will generally go for one step. Big customers, mm-hmm. because they want to avoid the risk, they will go step by step.
Yeah, right. Okay, thanks.
Gaurav, on the same token, do you know if SAP is selling this simple logistics and simple finance as one packet, or smaller packets?
No. See, when you are talking about SAP S/4HANA 1610, it is including all.
Regardless whether client wants to implement just logistic, simple finance today and
No. See, it is, yes. See, if you are going for 1610, you don't have a choice. See, you cannot decide whether I want to use logistic simplifications or finance, because it is a change in the architectural level, right? So for example, after implementing 1610, you cannot decide I want to use old credit management. That is not at all possible.
Okay. So it comes as a package.
Yes. And again, if you want only financials to be simplified, you can go for simple finance. But if you have the if you want to go only for logistics simplifications, that is not available, right? Because there is nothing called a simple logistics add-on like it was for simple finance. Simple logistics already comes up with simplified finance.
Okay.
Yes.
Without simplifying the simple finance, without implementing the simple finance, you can't put the simple logistics.
We cannot, yes. Because all our logistics simplifications are also based on the financial simplifications which they've done earlier.
Got it. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. This is Andrew. I have a question.
Yes.
Okay, just now you mentioned it's from EHP 1 through EHP 7, then what about EHP 8? Is that also supported for one step conversion?
Yes. See, EHP 8 came after they launched the Simple Finance. So that is also part of, so if you're on EHP 8, it can be, installed, it should be ECC 6.0, any EHP version.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
And last question.
Yes.
Hey,
sorry,
I'm not able to hear you. Yeah, maybe I muted now, right?
Yes.
So, see, we assume in simple finance, is there any change in MRP, or is there any specific, maybe have they changed in MRP, or it was like ERP 6?
See, as I told you earlier, when we talk about MRP Live, this MRP Live was even available in ECC also, but it was activated separately, right? Mm-hmm. So if you are going for SAP Simple Finance, okay, again, if you want MRP Live, you have to activate a business function. Okay, otherwise it will not be activated. But if you're going for SAP S/4HANA, this MRP Live is part of already provided solution, which is automatically active.
Okay, but in Simple Finance, it was not there. When it was a Simple Finance, this ERP was we have to activate maybe by a different process. That is what you want to say.
Yes. See, it is like if you are implementing Simple Finance, whatever processes from logistics point of view, MM, STPP, they will work exactly as they were working in EHP 7 without any change. So, for example, material ledger. Material ledger was optional in EHP 7, right? So, in Simple Finance also, it is optional. Credit management. You have a choice whether I want to use SD credit management or FSCM credit management. So, in Simple Finance also, you have a choice. Okay. Output determination. No, new output determination is not at all available in ECC. So it is not available in Simple Finance. Only the simplifications which were relevant to finance, they are available in Simple Finance.
Okay, Gaurav, thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gaurav, this is Sandeep here.
Yes.
Quick question.
Yeah. Terry, I think you must have got the answer. Yes, Sandeep, just one minute. Let me answer this question from Terry. She's asking on chat from long time. So Terry is asking, I think Terry, you got your answer. So Simple Finance, if I only install Simple Finance, how will be my integration affected? So as I told you, integration, whatever it was working in ECC, it will work as it is. Even in SAP S/4HANA, we are going to have once we complete this conversion, we are going to have a overview on Simple Finance, right? In that, I'll explain you how our integration is affected from starting from ECC to Simple Finance to SAP S/4. So anyways, we are going to discuss that topic once we complete the conversion. Yes, Sandeep, please go ahead.
So with these tools which we have, simplification database, basically once we before implementing to the SAP HANA, so we would be running those within the comparison with the any database to SAP HANA, right? So even do we need to run once the software update manager to get everything is done for upgrading to the SAP S/4HANA, and any other possibility that that could corrupt the systems in upgraded or implemented on the S/4HANA. So in that situation also, do we need to run reuse these tools over there in the new implemented system? That did we any breakage or something?
Sorry Sandeep, can you come again? Sorry, I missed what you're saying.
Okay, as simple like once upgrade is completed, or once the new implemented is done on S/4HANA, so can these tools which are already there, right, simplification of database, do we need to rerun that to verify that everything is fine, or something still got broken there before we totally move to the production?
No, you cannot use these tools. These tools have a purpose. These tools are used just to tell you what will be impacted. You cannot run the same tools to identify whether everything has been migrated correctly or not. So for that, SAP has provided different tools. We'll talk about that, because we are still talking about from the preparation point of view, like we are preparing to migrate to S4. Once we migrate to S4, then there are different tools which will tell you whether your migration has been completely performed well or there were some issues in the migration.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, Terry is asking a sample report from maintenance planner. I don't think so. You will be getting this sample report from maintenance planner. And additionally, what is the level of detail in maintenance planner? Example, does it shows your material is 18 and it has to be? Yes. These are all part of maintenance planner. Okay, so it will show you the detail, like whatever we discussed from the standard point of view. In short, your report on maintenance planner will be the subset of your simplification list, as I given you the example. So in procurement, if you go to the simplification list, you'll find there are 20 items which are mentioned. Now, out of this 20 items, even if you are working on SAP from, let's say you are a procurement consultant and you are working in SAP from 10 years, definitely out of that 20 items, 10 you have never heard about. Okay, because we ourselves, like as a consultants also, every customer has different demands and there are a lot of functionalities, old functionalities, new functionalities in SAP, which are used only 1 or 2%. So what happens is if you tell the customer, just show him the simplification list, this 20 functionalities will be affected. He will say, out of this 20, I'm only using 5. But instead of he identifying which 5 functionalities he's using, this maintenance planner will automatically perform the scan and it will give him the report that, okay, you are only using this 5 functionalities and this will be impacted. So it is a subset of what you are getting in the simplification list. And you will be getting the complete details, yes. Okay, so whatever we discussed about, so maintenance planner, it checks the business functions, it checks the add-ons, and it checks the industry-specific solutions, I told you. Just one example here. There are some business function statuses. Are you aware of business functions? Are you aware of what are the business functions in SAP? Okay, let me take you to SAP server first. Just give me a minute. Let me know once you're able to see SAP screen. Can you see SAP screen now?
Yes, Gaurav.
Okay. Have you seen the screen? SFW5 switch framework. Okay, there are a lot of no's, so I'll explain this. What is this exactly? See, SAP, as you know, it consists of lot of features. Okay, and any customer, if you go for small customer, big customer, they might be using only, let's say, 20, 30 or some of the customers, maximum they can be using around 60% of the features which are available in SAP. None of the customer uses entire 100% features, right? So let's say, for example, there are some functionalities available from SAP, and based on the customer's requirement, this functionalities needs to be activated or deactivated. Just to give a simple example, FSCM credit management normally was not used from the customers, right? So that was that you have a choice. You can come here in the business function. There are some business functions here. So for each and every functionality, there is one business function which is provided by SAP. So if you want to deactivate a particular functionality, let's say I don't want to use FSCM credit management, I'll go to that business function and I'll say deactivate or activate. So you can see here, these are the different business functions which are provided by SAP. Now, some of these business functions are customer switchable, which means you can decide whether this can be activated or not activated. While some of the business functions, they are always active. You cannot decide whether they needs to be, like whether you can activate or deactivate. And some of the business functions are always off, which means they are, you cannot activate them. They are related to the obsolete functionalities which are no more supported. Can you see the screen? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, Gaurav. I can see.
Okay, I think my screen is stuck. Let me open another screen. Yeah, now it is working. Okay. See, these are the business functions. Now, based on the functionalities, these business functions can be technical, functional. Let me show you some of the functionals which are easy to understand. System is very slow. Yeah, let's say, for example, SAP cash management. Now, this is a feature which is available in SAP, and it is up to the client whether they want to use it or not, right? So this is the place where you specify whether this function is activated or not. Now, as you can see here, this tick means this function is activated, and you get the information here, like who has activated and which version it is activated. All this information you are getting here. Some of the business functions, as you can see, this business function is obsolete and cannot be activated. So you cannot, you don't have the choice to activate this business function. This is not available in SAP S/4HANA, for example. Okay, so some of, in short, what I mean to say here is some of the business functions, you can decide as a client whether you want to use it or not. Some of the business functions, they are always active, which are not available here at all because you don't have a choice. And some of the business functions, they are always not active because they are related to obsolete functionalities. So when you run this maintenance planner in ECC system, now ECC system has different settings than S4. So whatever business functions were available in ECC, there are some business functions which were always on in ECC, which means they were automatically activated for each and every client. But now in SAP S/4HANA, let's say these functionalities are not available, so they must be always off, right? So all these things are checked when you run the maintenance planner from the business function point of view. So just for example, I'll give you one or two examples. FSCM credit management functionality, in ECC, it was customer switchable. You can decide whether I want to use it or not. Now in SAP S/4HANA, because you don't have the choice, you always have to use FSCM credit management. So that might be available in SAP S/4HANA as a always on. You cannot deactivate it. Material ledger, again, same example. In ECC, material ledger was a choice. If you want to activate, come here and activate it. If you don't want to activate, leave it blank. Now in SAP S/4HANA, since it is a mandatory functionality, it is always required to be activated. So you don't have the choice to activate or deactivate. So when you run this maintenance planner, it will tell you which of the business functions have the changed requirement. So it will tell you in ECC, you have not activated material ledger. You have not activated this business function, but in SAP S/4HANA, because material ledger is mandatory, this will be automatically set to active. So that kind of reports you'll be getting in maintenance planner, including the business functions, including the add-ons and industry solutions. So for example, one of the industry that you are using in ECC, let's say that is not supported in SAP S/4HANA. I'm just giving the example. Most of the industries are already supported. So when you run the maintenance planner, it will tell you, okay, you are using this industry specific solution, which is not supported in S4. So there itself, you can take a decision that, okay, if this industry specific specific solution which I'm using from years is not supported, I should wait till the time SAP comes up with the solution. All right, so that is the detailed level of reporting that you get from the maintenance planner. Let me go back to my PPT. Next to the maintenance planner is pre-check reports. As I told you, pre-check reports are the final checks which are performed, which will perform the readiness check. It will tell you whether your system, ECC system, is ready to be migrated to S4 or not. And as I told you, what level of checks are performed, we'll be discussing in once we complete this understanding of these tools, I'll explain you all the phases again, and this pre-checks will be part of that. Custom code check, as I told you. What is custom code check? Custom code check will check all your existing custom codes which are available in ECC, whether they will be impacted in SAP S4HANA or not. Now, this is very important to understand, like how exactly your system will know whether the custom code is supported or not. So let's let's understand my example. Currently you are using ECC, and now there are hundreds of custom objects. You want to know whether they will be impacted or they will be available as it is. Simple, right? Now, in order to check, what you need a simplification list, and you need the customer system, so that you go to one custom code. Let's say you are doing this activity manually. Let's understand you are doing this activity manually. Now what you will do, you will first go to first report and see which tables are used. So you identified the tables which are used are MKPF, MSEC, and MARC. So you checked whether there is any impact on MKPF, MSEC, and MARC. You checked in the simplification database, simplification list, it is saying MKPF is no more available, MSEC is no more available, MARC is not going to update the unrestricted quantity. But even if these tables are not available, they are available as a view, so there will be no impact on your reporting. So you decided, okay, this report, no problem, continue. You identified second report in which data is trying to come from table KONV. And as I told you, KONV is no more available, and the view also is not available, which means you manually need to update KONV to PRCD underscore elements, right? So this report you identified, there is a problem, right? Simple. So you, in the system, you checked which table is used, and you checked in the simplification list whether KONV is supported or not. You got the answer in simplification list that no, this is not supported, and you've taken a decision that there is an adjustment required. Now, same way, you cannot perform this simplification, you cannot perform these checks for each and every report. There are thousands of reports in SAP, custom reports. So you want a tool. So you got this custom code check. But the idea is same. What the tool will do, tool will also do the same thing. It will check what tables you are using. It will check in the simplification list whether these tables are available or not. If not, it will give you the error message. Now the question is, if I'm migrating to 1511 from ECC, if I'm migrating to 1511, my simplification list is different. And if I'm migrating to 1610, that is different, right? Simplification list is different than 1511 and 1610. So when I'm performing this check, I should be sure whether I want to go for 1511 or 1610, right? There can be table which is available in 1511 but not available in 1610. So what I need is the referring document which I am referring. I must be 100% sure whether I am comparing my existing ECC system with 1511 or 1610. Not only 1511 or 1610. Again, we know that within 1610 also, so SPS1, SPS2, there are different SPAs available. So you must be 100% sure, first of all, which version you are upgrading to. Based on that only, you will be performing these checks. Now your ECC system, you want to perform this activity automatically, right? Using this custom code check. So how your ECC system will know, where are you going? Are you going to 1511 or you are migrating to 1610? So in ECC system, you need to upload the simplification database. The simplification database you can download from this site. If I click on this, it will open to some link which will provide you the simplification database in the zip file. It is actually taking you to the service marketplace, and there in that service marketplace you can see there are different zip files available for each and every version. Who is going to do this? This is definitely the technical task. Okay, so your technical persons, they will download this zip file, they will upload this in your current ECC system client 000. Then only when the simplification database is available, then only the comparison can be performed, right? So you are comparing your ECC custom codes with the simplification list that you downloaded from here. Okay, so zip files are available for each and every version in the service marketplace. You definitely need your the user ID and password to download it, and you may not be able to use your user ID and password. You need the company's user ID and password to download this zip file. Once you download this zip file, you need to upload into your current system, and then you will be running some programs which will be checking your existing custom codes vis-a-vis the file that you have uploaded. Is it clear? How are you going to perform the custom code check? As a functional consultant, you will be getting the result of that activity. All this downloading of zip file, uploading, running the report, this will be done by your technical consultant. You will be getting the final result, which will tell you which custom codes are impacted, and out of those custom codes, how much are actually used. So the usage history also you'll be getting, so that you can decide whether I should concentrate on this custom code or I can completely skip this. Finally, the software update manager. As I told you, this is a tool which will be used to actually perform the conversion. Okay, to actually convert your system from ECC to S4, the tool that will be used by your technical guys will be software update manager. Okay, now as I told you, before you run this software update manager, you need to make sure that you run maintenance planner, you run the pre-check reports, you have done the custom code analyzer, and then only you are coming here in software update manager. So this is a tool that will be used to convert your system to SAP S/4HANA. And in your system, if your system is not yet running on SAP HANA database, you can use this option, as I told you, DMO, which will not only convert your application to S/4HANA, but also convert your database from traditional database to SAP HANA database. Just one check, I want to check with you. I hope you understand this, but just to make sure. So you are using SAP ECC today, and you are migrating to SAP S4. But why it is only showing on-premise? Why not cloud? I hope you can answer this very easily. I think we discussed this earlier. My question is, in the conversion process, can I move to cloud?
But I think the cloud is already upgraded.
You are right, but can you just explain?
I believe that cloud is always advanced, and there is no kind of choice to make a conversion, as I understand.
No. Terry, you are also not right. Terry is saying it depends upon the version purchased. Even if I purchase cloud, can I perform the conversion? Just think about this. It is a very simple answer. I'll give you the example. Conversion is what you are upgrading from, simple example, EHP 6 to EHP 7. That is also the conversion, right? So if you are using EHP 6, just same question I'm asking. This is the question. We cannot move to cloud. We cannot convert our existing system to cloud. But what is the reason I'm trying to understand? I'm not getting the answer. I thought maybe this will be very easy for you because we already discussed this, and this is very straightforward. If I tell you, it will be very good. It will be very simple.
And when you say cloud, is it a pub?
Not clear answer. Sorry?
When you say cloud, there's a public and private, right? And the public is always upgraded, and by, I think, quarterly upgraded by SAP.
Okay. Let me answer. Not very clear answers. Let me just read the answer which is provided by Sandeep. No, Sandeep, this is also not correct. Okay. See, conversion is what? Conversion is when you are upgrading your current system. Upgrading your current system. Just read these lines. Upgrading your current system. And what is your current system? Your current system is on-premise. Okay. Upgrading your current system. If I am already having a system which I am performing the upgrade, so that means I am using my own system, I'm upgrading it. So let's say if I am using a server in which SAP ECC is installed. When I'm saying conversion, I am upgrading my current system. So maybe hardware upgradation is also required. I'll depute more RAM, and the functional upgradation is also required from SAP S/4HANA point of view, which means whatever hardware I have, I'm using the same hardware. So there is no question of cloud here. It is on-premise. If I want to go on cloud, okay, if I decide that, okay, today I'm using my on-premise system, I want to go on cloud, that cannot be termed as conversion. That is something which you are going away with your current system and migrating your data to cloud. That will be treated as a new implementation. Is it clear or confusion? I'll explain you once again. Although it should be clear, but let me explain this. Let's say today I am running my EHP 6 system. Okay. And I want to migrate to EHP 7. I have two options. Option number one, I'm using the same system. I'll just run the upgrade. It will be converted to EHP 7. So what I'm saying is I'm using the current system. My current system is on-premise, and I'm upgrading it to EHP 7. So definitely EHP 7 will be also on-premise. Second option is I want to use EHP 7, but that EHP 7 I want on cloud. So in that case, if I want to go on cloud, I cannot upgrade my current system because my current system is on-premise. In that case, it will be treated as a new implementation because I have to move my current data from my on-premise system to cloud. So that is not a conversion, that is a new implementation. Similar is the case with SAP S/4HANA. If you are upgrading your current system, this means your current system is on-premise and you are upgrading it. So your new system will become SAP S/4HANA on-premise system. If you have a need of cloud, that will be treated as a new implementation. Is it clear? This is very important. So if you are going to the customer and if he's asking you, I want to perform the conversion, but I want to move on to cloud. So your answer should be, in that case, definitely you can go on cloud. That is not a restriction. But the problem is, whatever Z codes, whatever custom codes you are using, they are not available on cloud. And I can move only your standard data from your current system to cloud because cloud doesn't support the Z codes, right? You cannot, if you are using public cloud, you cannot use your Z codes in the cloud. That will be treated as a new implementation. But if you want to use your same custom codes, everything same, only the new features should be added, then I can perform the conversion on your existing system, which will be migrated to SAP S4. And but that will remain as your on-premise system. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, now let me, as I told you, I'll be providing you the detailed explanation on the phases. So you just understood the tools now. What we done from now till now was understanding the tools. What will be the tools used when you perform the conversion? Now let's focus on what is the process? What are the different phases in the conversion project? Okay, so I'm opening the notepad and I'll share this notepad with you. So whatever I'm explaining, I'll just write it here. I don't have a PPT as of now. Maybe I'll add this into my slides also. So when you talk about a conversion process, this first explanation which I'm giving, this is already on the slide, but whatever I'll be using for next 1 hour, that is something that I'll be sharing with you via this notepad. I don't know, this server is very slow today. Okay, so conversion process consists of 5 different phases. First is the preparation phase. Second is installation. Third is delta config. Fourth is data migration. And finally, fifth is post migration. So these are the 5 phases that you perform in the conversion project. Now, what comes under the preparation? So you got a project in the sense you got an opportunity to work on the project, and customer is asking you, if I want to migrate to SAP S/4HANA, can you tell me what will be the impact on my standard business processes, custom codes? So you normally start the project from there. So what you will do, you will perform this, you will use these tools like maintenance planner, simplification database, which is nothing but simplification database is nothing but custom code analyzer. And this will give the confidence to the customer that, okay, now he knows what will be the impact on my business processes if I want to go for SAP S/4HANA. So after this maintenance planner and custom code analyzer, customer said, okay, I now know what will be the impact on my business processes. I want to go ahead with implementation or conversion to SAP S/4. Okay, so first of all, in the preparation, you started with the checking the system and telling the user, customer, what will be impacted. Once you got the go ahead and you started a project, what you will do? You will perform various preparation activities. Now, preparation activities, apart from this maintenance planner and custom code analyzer, from logistics point of view, a very important activity is converting customers and vendors to business partners. This activity you have to do in ECC itself. Because once you migrate to S4, you will not be able to see your customers and vendors if they are not available as business partners, right? So in the preparation itself, you are going to perform the conversion of customers and vendors to business partners. Apart from this, there are a lot of preparation checks which are required from financial point of view. So your period end closing should be performed. Your reconciliation report should be run. These are all the preparation activities that you perform from finance point of view. Okay, so preparation means what? Whatever activities you are doing on ECC system. So in the bracket, one single answer for what is preparation is whatever activities you perform on current ECC system. Okay, so preparation means whatever activities are performed on your current ECC system. Once you performed all these activities, once you converted your customers and vendors to business partners, you performed the period end closing, you performed the reconciliation, everything is done, then you are ready to install. What are you going to install? Install the new components, right? What you will use to install the new components? What your technical consultant will use? Any idea which tool will be used to perform the installation? We already discussed installation using tools we discussed now, right? Yes, SCM, Software Update Manager is the tool that will be used. So installation using Software Update Manager, SUM. SUM is a tool which will be used to perform the installation. Who will perform the installation? Technical guys. Which technical guys? It can be basis, HANA. Okay, all these technical guys will be performing the installation of S/4HANA. What do you mean by installation? So till here, in the preparation phase, the version that we were using from SAP was ECC. And all these activities, delta configuration, data migration, post migration, this we want to do on SAP S4. Okay, but who will convert our existing system from ECC to S4? That will be converted during the installation phase. So when the technical team will perform the installation, all the changes, technical changes that we discussed, tables will be removed, views will be created. Okay, whatever things we discussed are going to change the architecture, the way in which the data is going to be stored, that will be done during the installation phase. Okay, once the installation is done, then you are going to perform these three steps: delta config, data migration, and post migration. Now, how are you going to do this? So we already know for preparation, SAP provided these tools: maintenance planner, custom code analyzer. For installation, SAP provided Software Update Manager. But what about this? For these three phases, has SAP provided some tools? The answer is yes. If I go to SPRO, SAP IMG, migration to SAP S/4HANA Finance. This is a complete cockpit. Now this cockpit is divided into three different folders. This folder is related to delta configuration. This folder is related to data migration. And this folder is related to post migration. That is exactly what you want to do, right? So once our technical team has converted our ECC to SAP S4 and handed over to us, we will be able to see the screen, migration to SAP S/4HANA Finance. And in this screen, we can see three folders. Okay, and we need to perform all these activities in a particular sequence. Okay, so ECC system has been converted to S4 technically, but functionally, before we hand it over the system to the end user to perform his task, we need to make sure that all these three activities are completed, and then only system can be given to the end user. Okay, so these three activities that we need to perform, they are called as migration cockpit. This entire folder, migration to S/4HANA Finance, is nothing but migration cockpit, which consist of different programs which are provided by SAP to convert our existing data in old architecture to new architecture. So whatever has been changed, material ledger, credit management, this tool will be used to perform that migration. So if my current data in ECC is available in old inventory valuation tables, using this cockpit, I'll move my data from old tables to new material ledger tables. In ECC, if I was using SD credit management, so whatever data was stored in SD credit management, that needs to be migrated to FSCM credit management, right? So this is a tool that will be used for data migration. Why it is called as migration to SAP S/4HANA Finance? Because from logistics point of view, most of the architectural changes will happen as soon as installation is performed. Okay, so there is less of delta configuration and more of the data configuration is related to finance. That is the reason if I open this configuration, you will see a lot of financial related configuration. Let's say general ledger accounting, asset accounting, controlling, bank accounting. But from logistics point of view, only two: material ledger and credit management. And that too, material ledger and credit management is not only logistics, it has a very strong financial impact, right? That is the reason there is no separate cockpit available for logistics. Same cockpit that we use for finance, it includes the activities related to material.